What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRider.com and welcome to my fourth PL SQL tutorial for beginner series. The topic of today's tutorial is anchor data type in PL SQL. In this tutorial, we will learn about anchor data type, how to declare them in PL SQL and its uses. So without wasting much of your time, let's get started. So what are anchor data types in PL SQL? Anchor data types are those data types which you assign to a variable based on a database object. They are called anchor data type because unlike the variable's data type, it is not dependent on that of underlying object. Let's take a quick look at anchor data type syntax. So here is our syntax. Here variable name is a user defined name given to a variable. And a type attribute can be anything such as previously declared PL SQL variable or column of a table. And at the end, percentage type is the direct reference to the underlying database object. In order to better understand the concept of anchor data type, let's do some examples. Okay, so here I am on my SQL developer. For the demonstration, I have created a table by the name of students, which has two columns, stuID with data type number and data width 2, and first name with data type varchar 2 and data width 8. I have also inserted two rows into this table. Next, I will write an anonymous block where I will declare a variable with anchor data type and then I will initialize that variable by fetching values from this table. So let's do it. Here in the declaration section, I have declared a variable by the name of v_fname with identical data type as the column first name of table students. This means that the data type of variable v_fname will be the varchar 2 with data width 8, which is the data type and data width of the column first name of our table students. What I just did here is that I simply wrote the name of our table, which is student, followed by the dot operator and the column name first name, followed by the keyword percentage type. This will assign the data type and data width of the column first name to our variable v_fname. That's how we declare a variable with anchor data type. Isn't it simple? Okay, so let's add execution section to this anonymous PL SQL block and initialize this variable v_fname by fetching data from the table students. Here in this execution block, I have a select into statement using which I am fetching first name of the student whose stuID is 1 and storing it into our variable v_fname. If you are confused about this select into statement, then I encourage you to watch my previous video where I explain this specific topic in detail complete with easy examples. Link is in the description or on the right hand corner of your screen. That said, let's execute this block. And here we got an error. That's because I must have done something wrong. So what? I'm also a human being. Let's see where is the mistake. And okay, here in the declaration section, the name of the table is students, not student. Okay, let's close this script output and try to execute this anonymous block once again. Okay, here is our result. Now you must be thinking, what are the applications of this kind of data type? Why do we need them? To answer this question, let me quickly write another block. Then I will demonstrate you application of anchor data type. But before that, let me close this script output. Okay, done. This is the same code as of the previous one, except that this time we have a normal variable declaration with data type varchar 2 and data width 8 instead of anchor data type as we had in our last PL SQL block. As we are initializing the variable v_fname by fetching values from base table students, hence making this variable dependent on column of the table whose value we are storing into it. That means this variable must have the same data type and data width as of the base column, which in our case is the first name column of a student table. Now this is the problem. What if you don't know the data type and data width of column of the base table? Or suppose you knew the data type and data width and you designed your block according to that, but now after a few months someone came and changed the definition of the base column. Now your code will not work. In this case, this type of anchor data type helps. No matter what happened to the base table or its column, it always keeps your code and its variable in sync. Let's see. Let me execute this code. This will work fine since the variable definition is according to the base table. See, here is the result. Now, I will change the data type of the column first name of our table students from varchar 2 to jar and data width from 8 to 10. So let's first close this script output and make some space so that you people can see things clearly. Okay, done. Now let's write the code. Let's execute. Table students altered. So now let's try executing our last anonymous block once again. And here it is. This time we get an error. Now to solve this error, let's change the data type of our variable from normal varchar 2 to anchored data type. Okay, let's close this script output and try to execute this anonymous block once again. Here is our result. That is an application of anchored data type. Hope you enjoyed it and learned something. With this, I will wind up today's tutorial. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and share it on your Facebook or other social network with your friends. You can follow me on my Twitter and Instagram. Links are on your screen or in the description box. Don't forget to subscribe. I will be back soon with another tutorial. Till then, stay tuned and take care. I'm Manish from Rebellion Rider.